Yo me trago y tú.
First of all, introduce yourself.
I'm Marco Herrera.
Yeah, yeah, of course, yes.
Marco Herrera's son.
And Jesus Soto Krause, of course. Now, Marco, I've asked you many times over the years, do you want to come back? The answer is always no, I'm good, I'm happy. What made you come back for this big charity event, June 11, in Pico Rivera?
Sí, no, la verdad, yo nunca, siempre he sido neurrente, no me ha gustado subirme arriba del ring, pero yo creo que ahora todo vino a cambiar. Este encierro, este vivir diferente, este platicar con la gente que no vio a un Marco Antonio Barrera, a un Soto Caraz arriba del ring, ahora lo va a poder ver en este tipo de exhibiciones.
He's always had that mentality, I'm not coming back to the ring. But because of the pandemic, because of everything that was going on, the people started talking and the people started demanding to see people like Soto Caraz, Marco Antonio Barrera back in the ring. So that's what changed his mind.
I always told people, you could see Muhammad Ali fight one more time, you would do it. So it's a big honor for fans to see you fight again. Now you're sitting near and you guys are friendly, but you're gonna try to hurt him, he's gonna try to hurt you. Are you ready for that fight?
Están listos para la pelea, de que ahorita están los dos así amigos, los cotorreando, pero ya que arriba en el ring, pues obviamente las cosas son diferentes. ¿Están listos?
No, las cosas son diferentes. Todos sabemos que dos mexicanos arriba de un cuadrilátero, todo puede pasar. En verdad, Soto Caraz es un guerrero. Se lo he dicho una y tres veces en las entrevistas que a mí me tocó verlo caer, levantarse, a dar espectáculo. En mi caso, pues, la gente sabe cuál es mi estilo, entonces la gente no se puede perder esta exhibición con Soto Caraz.
People can't miss this fight. This everything is different in the ring, especially when two Mexicans are in the ring. It's gonna be a great fight. He said it multiple times now. He thinks Soto Caraz thrown down in the ring, but he comes back and wins the fight. So this is definitely gonna be a great fight.
It will be a great fight. What did you think of Oscar Valdez's win over Burchett? It was a big shock.
¿Qué opinas sobre esa pelea, Oscar Valdez?
Fíjate que Oscar Valdez es tanto para la Gran Berche son grandes amigos, pero creo que el estilo que sacó el Valdez en la forma de moverse, usar el cuadrilátero, la rapidez, fue lo que marcó la diferencia, sin demeritar lo que hizo el campeón del mundo también. Quién sabe qué haya pasado, si le pasó, si le afectó, que le haya dado Kobe, no sabemos. Tal vez en una segunda pelea lo podremos ver.
Well, this strategy was definitely what marked the difference. He was using the ring, he was using everything as advantage. Also, for the champ, for the Alacrán, we don't know what happened to him. Maybe it was COVID, maybe it was another thing, maybe he just had a bad night. But it was definitely a great strategy from Valdez.
Loma or Valdez, who wins?
No, this is a great fight, but I think Loma.
Soy mexicano, yo voy Valdez.
He's Mexican, he's going Valdez.
Valdez, Andy Ruiz. Okay, Andy Ruiz, Chris Arreola, who wins?
Yo tengo buena con Andy Ruiz, fíjate que a mí me gusta su estilo, me gusta su... De hecho, la predicción, cuando él le ganó a Anthony Yesua, la hice yo en TV Azteca. Nadie le creía a mis... Andy Ruiz y fue como ganó noche.
He likes Andy Ruiz, he's always been with Andy Ruiz, especially on the fight with Anthony Joshua. He was the only one within his peers that said Anthony Judge is going to lose his fight against Andy Ruiz. So he's always going to stay with Andy Ruiz.
What do you think? You know both of them. Who wins, Andy Ruiz or Chris Arreola?
I think Andy Ruiz.
Andy Ruiz?
That's a good fight, but I think Andy Ruiz.
How good of a trainer is Eddie Reynoso? Ryan Garcia, Canelo, Andy, Oscar.
Pues sí es muy bueno porque trae al mejor boxeador libra por libra y yo creo que también depende de un boxeador que sea disciplinado más yendo de la mano de un extraordinario entrenador, es lo mejor.
I mean, he has the best pound for pound boxer, so he definitely speaks about a lot about him as a trainer, but it also depends a lot on the boxer. He needs to be disciplined, he needs to listen to his trainer, but Eddie Nelson is a good trainer.
If Manny Pacquiao fights Crawford and beats Crawford, does that make him the best fighter in history? Does that make him the best ever?
Yeah, I think for the age, he got like 42 years old. He beat Crawford, man. That's a great fighter, Manny Pacquiao.
No, Manny Pacquiao se convirtió en el mejor boxeador de la historia desde que ganó, me parece que 6 o 7 títulos en diferentes divisiones. Nadie lo ha hecho. Yo creo que ahorita lo que va a hacer Manny Pacquiao es tal vez sumarle una victoria, gran victoria a su récord, pero también lleva mucha peligrosidad esa pelea.
6-7 world titles in 6-7 weight categories, that made him the best fighter in history. Right now, if he beats Terry Crawford, that is just another win to his resume.
And my last question, you and Eric Morales, number 4, yes?
Sí.
And what happens, a knockout?
ya va a estar, no sabemos qué va a pasar, pero después del 11 de junio platicaremos de esa exhibición.
We'll talk about that fight after this one, but it's definitely going to happen.
Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you. Follow Jesus Otocross on Instagram, Jesus Otocross.
Marco Barrera T.
And your Instagram?
My Instagram, Marco Barrera Jr.
Thank you so much, everybody. We appreciate it. Stay tuned. For EsNews.com and Elie Seckbach reporting. Thank you.